श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे उपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्रृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः स यथा दुन्दुभेः हन्यमानस्य न बाह्यान् शब्दान् शक्नुयाद् ग्रहणाय दुन्दुभेस्तु ग्रहणेन दुन्दुभ्याघातस्य वा शब्दो गृहीतः लुकिंगड्डी भाष्य न तो ते एव निर्भिद्य ग्रहीतुं शक्यन्ते विशेषरूपेण अभावात् तेषाम्. सो द आइडिया इज देर इज दि शब्द सामान्य एंड दि दुंदुभि इज बीटन द जनरल साउंड. नाउ यू से देर आर सम पर्टिकुलर साउंड्स ऑफ म्यूजिक इन दैट म्यूजिक रिलेटेड साउंड्स आर देर इन इट. If you say they are there in it, okay, take it out and show us. Like the scabbard has a sword inside it, and you can take it out and show it. Similarly, you take out your tadhiganatom, etc., from the general sound and show us. You cannot. Nirbhidya grahitum nasakyante. Because vishesha rupena abhavat tesham. Because what you are saying, they do not exist in as particulars. The way the namarupa, particular means namarupa, the way you imagine, they do not exist there. Vishesha rupena, tadhiginatom, tatha, dadhi, dagi, that is the vishesha rupa. And these vishesha rupas, are they present in that shabda samanya? They are not present. You are superimposing, you should understand that. You are putting it there. They are not there in it. So this is the example. Tatha prajnanavyatirekena svapna jagaritayoho nakaschid vastu visheshaha krahiyate. So similarly, prajnana is there. Other than prajnana, distinct from prajnana, vyatireka is distinct. What is prajnana? Sphuranatmaka brahma samanya. That is very beautifully written by the Tikakara. So prajnana is in the form of atma is a swarupam. What is prajnana? You see, whenever there is a sphuranam, that is prajnana. Sphuranam. So rupajnanam, I look at it. The moment I see it, there is a jnanam, crystal jnanam. So crystal becomes evident. So evidence of crystal, that is prajnana. Prajnana is always in the form of evidence of crystal, evidence of book, evidence of this, evidence of that. That is the form of the prajnana. And this prajnana is brahma, prajnanam brahma. Therefore he says, spuranatmaka brahma samanya. You see, I tell you the samanya. When you say the spurana, the evidence of the book, the evidence of the pot, the evidence of the flower, the evidence of the friend, the evidence of the foe. When you say that, what is the samanya in that? Brahma is the samanya. Prajnanam brahma is the samanya. And that samanya alone is, like shabda samanya. What about tadhiganatom? They are not there. Similarly, here also, whatever you think that you are evidencing, oh, I see this, I see that, like that, is a namarupa, they just do not exist. So, therefore you can only say the content of the waking state, that is the waking consciousness content. That content is what is called you, what you call the world. What you call the world, you see, this thing has to come into your mind. This has to sink into your mind. What you call the world is nothing more than the content of your consciousness. And that content of the consciousness is like tadhiginato means shabda samanya. Means it appears to be particular, 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 like that. It appears to be without really being there. Therefore, the content of the consciousness is not real. The consciousness alone, real. This applies to waking state, and this applies to the dream state also. Svapna jagrita yoho nakaschit vastu visheshaha gruhiyate. Gruhiyate means nagruhiyate. So, whatever object that you say, vastu vishesha, this object, see, what you call matter is none other than matter consciousness. You should know that. There is no matter. There is no such animal called matter other than matter consciousness. So, therefore, what he says is vastu visheshaha nagrihyate. A particular vastu, it is not there. You cannot establish its presence. So, what is this particular vastu? Whatever is sphuryamanaha, whatever is appearing as bleep. I am not talking of kshanika vijnanavada, but sphuranam is like a bleep. So now my friend, a bleep. Now my foe, bleep, like that. Whatever is appearing like that, the entire content of consciousness, that content, it just doesn't exist in real terms. Only prajnana exists. You see, once King Janaka had a dream. This is the usual story. The moment you say svapna jagrita yoho, this story comes. You have to say that. Because that story indicates to a receptive mind how illusory we are in our lives. That's why the story has to be told. The receptive mind will understand the significance of the story. So the King Janaka had a dream, and in the dream he was a beggar. He must have seen a beggar here and there, so he became a beggar himself. So he woke up, and then he is obviously a king. So he asked his teacher, Vasishtha, Yajnavalkya, Rashtavakra, whosoever some teacher, he asked him, so, am I a king dreaming of being a beggar, or am I a beggar dreaming of being a king? See, this is the question. The day you ask this question, you are liberated, I tell you. Because nobody asks this question. So, I am a doctor. Yesterday, I had a dream in which I was a patient. And therefore, he thinks that the doctor is real and patient is unreal. But it doesn't occur to him. It could as well be the other way. Because, you know, dream is of short duration. I was telling you yesterday, the duration of time doesn't matter. Dream is unreal. So, the duration is 5 minutes. Waking state is unreal. Waking state is real because duration is longer. You say like that. The duration doesn't matter. The dream begins and ends. Same way, waking state begins and ends. And therefore, both are just the same. Both are equally unreal. And so just because one time scale is short and another time scale is large, that doesn't make it any better. This is what I used to say. When we go to the movie, they first show a documentary, 10 minutes. And then they show the regular movie, the feature presentation. So it is 3 hours. Now which is real? So the feature presentation is real and the documentary is unreal. If the documentary is unreal, then the feature presentation is also unreal. Therefore, this is the question of Janaka. Then the teacher answered, you are neither. The teacher answered, you are neither. First you have to understand that you are both. people think that I am the doctor of the waking state, I am not the patient of the dream state. He thinks like that. He first should know that I am both. In fact, I am neither. So, when you say I am both, it is Sarvatma Bhava. When you say I am neither, it is called Viveka. Anyway, you see, you are not what you think yourself to be. First, you should understand that. You think yourself to be something or the other always. So you are not what you think yourself to be. These are all adhyasas. Adhyaropa. Adhyasa means adhyaropa. So they say to him, you are a brahmachari. Till then he never knew what is a brahmachari. But now he has picked up that. And so when you ask a brahmachari, who are you? He tells, I am a brahmachari. Then they put another adhyaropa to him. They wait for him to become 20 or 25 year old and put another adhyaropa upon him. You are a grihastha. This adhyaropa comes with a lot of paraphernalia. And so you are a grihastha. And he takes it. Like the fish gulps the hook. Similarly, he takes this adhyaropa upon himself. I am a grihastha. And then after a while, if he has any wisdom, he should accept one more adhyaropa that erases this grahastha adhyaropa. Every new adhyaropa erases the old one. So I am a vanaprastha, not anymore grahastha. And this vanaprastha comes to the Vedanta class. So he has to enter, before entering into the class, he has to erase all adhyaropas and put on a new adhyaropa called I am a jijnyasu. Every time, whatever you think of yourself to be, you are not. I will ask you, suppose this person says he got a dream and he is the doctor. In the dream he was a patient. Can you remain a patient forever? No. Therefore you are not a patient, certainly. Because you were a patient for 5 minutes and therefore you are not a patient. Okay. You then what are you? I am a doctor. Can you remain a doctor forever? Not. Then why do you say I am a doctor? If you are a doctor, then you are as well a patient also, patient of the dream. So if the Janaka is a king, then he must be the beggar of the dream also. Therefore, everything changes. All must change. The patient will not remain patient forever. The doctor will not remain doctor forever. All must change. And you are not what changes. You are what does not change. So you tell me now, who are you? This is what the teacher asked Janaka. Janaka replied, I am neither the king nor the beggar. I am the dispassionate witness. That is the reply he gave. That is a good step forward. Therefore, prajnana vyatirekena kaschit vastu visheshaha nagruhiyate. The both states are equally unreal, and therefore nothing exists other than the prajnana. The entire content of the prajnana is unreal. The prajnana alone is real. Sayatha. Another vyatireka, another vakya. Tasmat. Prajnanam vyatirekena. Abhavaha. Yuktastesham. That is the conclusion. Yesterday there was a question. What is the conclusion of the drishtanta. This is the conclusion. Tasmat, therefore. What is the meaning of therefore? The Tikakara gives a very good meaning. Chidati rekena chetya agrahat. You see, there is prajnana, the consciousness, waking consciousness, that is called chit. Let us say, call it chit. Prajnana is also chaitanyam, you know, chit. Now, what is part? Part is that which becomes evident in waking consciousness, in chit. Part is that which becomes evident in chit. That's why part doesn't say, I am the part. You say part. So that means the part is now shining as purati in your consciousness, and therefore part has become the content of the consciousness. Unless it becomes the content of the consciousness, it cannot exist. There is no such existence at all. Therefore, whatever is the content of the consciousness, it is called chetya. Chit chetya. చిత్ చేత్య. సో దేర్ ఈస్ కాన్షియస్నెస్, నౌ పాట్. సో పాట్ ఇస్ ది చేత్య. దెన్ ఎ ఫ్లవర్, ఫ్లవర్ ఇస్ ది చేత్య. దిస్ వాట్ ఎవర్ యు ఆర్ కాలింగ్ దిస్ చేత్య, సో పాట్, ఫ్లవర్ ఎట్సెట్రా, దీస్ చేత్యాస్ దే డు నాట్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్, దే ఓన్లీ అపియర్. Therefore, their content, their matrix, their swarupa is nothing but chit. Therefore, other than chit, there is no chetya existing in this creation. Therefore, tasmat, that is the tasmat. Prajnana vyatirekena abhavo yuktaha. So you cannot take out the chetya and show this is the chetya other than chit. You cannot separate it like that. Therefore, we conclude chit. You see, without chetya, the chit can be there. But without chit, chetya cannot be there. Therefore, chetya is a particularity superimposed on the chit by the ignorant mind. Therefore, there is no chetya abhava. Abhava. Don't be hesitant. Be courageous enough to say, abhava, it just doesn't exist. Tesham. So, we thought it exists for a while because it appeared. As it appeared, you thought it exists. But understand, it doesn't exist. This is the conclusion. Sayatha shankhasya dhmayamanasya. This dhmayamana, this dhma is a very interesting dhatu. It is sanyukta, sanyukta akshara dhatu it is. So very few dhatus have that sanyukta. So that is the dhatu. ధమతి ధమతి శంఖం ధమతి లిట్ ఈజ్ దౌ దమతు దద్ధ్ము. సో దట్ ఈస్ ది ధాతు ధ్మా. అండ్ ఫర్ దట్ శానచ్ ఈజ్ యాడెడ్ ధ్మాయమానస్య, మీన్స్ కంటిన్యూస్లీ సంబడీ ఈజ్ బ్లోయింగ్ ది కాంచ్. శంఖస్య ధ్మాయమానస్య. Some people have a fancy for shankha. Something. You see, once I went for a conference, a kind of an interfaith conference, whatever. And this gentleman, he is supposed to give a lecture. And so what he did, you know, he came prepared with some notes, some book, etc., which we all do. And so he put it there, and from his pocket, very bulging pocket was there. And from that pocket, he took out quite a substantial size shankha, conch he took out. And then I thought he will show to the people, no? He just blew it first. Like Sri Krishna blowing the conch, or Arjuna blowing the conch, as the story tells. So he blew the conch. For half a minute, he went on and on. The mic is also there. The whole hall was reverberating. So Swamiji was also there in that conference. And then he put the shankha aside and started his lecture. Very interesting, you know. So you want to draw attention towards you. People are like that. They have that need to draw attention. They don't want to remain inconspicuous and melt away. No, not that way. Everybody should look at them. Some need, I suppose. So, shankhasya dhmayamanasya. So, shankha is being blown. Then, na vahyan shabdan shaknuyat grahanaya. When shankha is blowing, then some clever person or one who has a fertile imagination. So, he says, oh, you see that sound is now coming? The shankha sound, you don't bother, it is going on. But now, Om is coming. And then, Shivaya is also coming from that shankha. And Bham is coming. Bhum is coming. So like that he will be saying, Bham, Bham, Bham. Bole Nath, he is coming from that shankha. Like that he says. If he is a religious person, he will say like that. But if he has some other orientation, he will say something else. It all depends upon the orientation. Now, all these shabdas, which are outer, means which are not part of the shankha dhvani. Shankha dhvani is shankha dhvani, whatever it is. No, no, bham. Bham is not part of Shankadhvani. Bham is an outer. No, I see bham in the Shankha, Shankadhvani. The sound of the Shankha, I see bham. Okay, you show me. Bahyan shabdan shakna grahanaya na shaknuyat. You show me. Take it out and show me. This is bham and this is Shankha shabda samanya. Can you show like that? You cannot show. Therefore, Shankha shabda samanya alone is real. And all these Shankha shabda visheshas that you are superimposing, they are your fancy. They do not exist. First you fancy a thing and then say it exists. This is how we suffer in life. So, he fancies a friend and then says, I am attached to that person. Then he fancies a foe and says, I hate that person. There is no friend, there is no foe. Your imagination of the mind, which projects attachment and aversion, makes things appear like that. There is no friend, there is no foe. Only your imagination. Like this bham, bhum, etc. You imagine that they all exist in the Shankha Shabda Samanya. They just do not exist. You think they exist. Bhashyakara. Tatha. Tatha means and also, or as this example of the Dundubhi was understood in the same way, Sayatha Shankhasya Dhmayamanasya Shabdena Sanyojyamanasya. So in the same way, as you see in the world, the loka, saha drishtantaha yatha loke, so shankhasya dhvayamanasya. Shankha is being blown. Blow means you have to understand the meaning of the blow. There is nothing being blown out there. It is not a blow up. It is only a way of putting some sound into the Shankha. Shabdena sanyojyamanasya. You blow, you put a lot of sound into the Shankha, then the Shankha, it makes that sound reverberate or whatever. It is like a mic. Shankha is like a mic. Suppose I say, it doesn't make big sound. The same, if I do in Shankha, then Shankha will be filled with a lot of moisture and all that, but other than that, that happens. That happens anyway, you must have noticed it. Other than that, this sound will appear 100 times bigger or 10 times bigger in the Shankha. Therefore, so that is the Shabdena Sanyojyamanasya. First you have to impart some sound into it. Then the sound will come out bigger. Shankhas, that's why Shankha cannot be blown by a simple guy. One should be a bit sturdy for it. And one who has a lot of lung power alone can blow Shankha. There are people who are given to some good lung power. And only they can blow Shankha. If I try to blow Shankha, it just doesn't blow at all. One should have a lot of lung power. So, Shabdena Sanyojyamanasya. Shankara is not satisfied with the explanation. He says, Apuryamanasya. So, it is being filled with Shabda. A lot of Shabda you pour into it, you push into it. Then what happens? It comes out with Shankha Shabda Samanya. Nabahyan Shabdan Shaknuyat. So, whatever you superimpose shabdas onto that general sound of the Shankha, you cannot show them distinct from the general sound of the Shankha. That is the statement. Ityeva madi porvavat. So, all the description, etc., and the conclusions, they follow the same method as it is described in the earlier mantra. What is that? Purvavat, Shankara says, I also say Purvavat, then there is no class. So I have to tell what is Purvavat. So Purvavat means the world that you experience is but a show, very glittering, but empty. It is very glittering, but empty. You see, you have to understand the glitter versus content. You have to understand that. You see, I am looking at, let us say, movie I am seeing. On the movie screen, I am looking at a character. Let us say the hero, the macho guy. He is standing there. Hero, very bulky person and a 6-footer, he is standing there. And when people see him, they get thrilled, you know. In India, when they see hero, they get thrilled. So, you are looking at him. Even we are thrilled to a small extent, if not that expressive, at least partially we are also thrilled. That's why we watch the movie and you look at that. So, you ask yourself, what am I looking at? So, suppose you say, I am looking at a wonderful looking macho hero, if you say like that, then you are just making a mistake. You are not looking at all of that. Right? What are you are looking at? You are looking at just an outline of black and white. That is what you are looking at. And it is exactly that only, nothing more. It is just that only. This macho, wonderful, beloved hero and all that, it is just not there in it. So please understand that what you are looking at is a simple two-dimensional black and white outline. And it is not even three-dimensional. There is no depth in it. The hero, he is weighing, suppose you, that hero is there. He weighs how much? Oh, he must be weighing 100 kg. You see, including all that, all the contents of the screen and the screen itself and the what holds the screen behind, all of that put together doesn't weigh 100 kg. There is no depth in it. There is no weight to it. There is no quality to that. It is just a glitter. And there is no meaning to it. What is the meaning? A macho, marvelous looking hero. That is the meaning you are giving to it. That meaning is not there in it. And then it is all the way unreal. Then what is real? You are real. Only the onlooker is real. And the Atman alone is real. The world that appears in the Atma Chaitanyam is but a colorful show. It is not real. That is the meaning of the drishtanta. You see, you say world is there. Now, what is this world is made up of? You ask this question. What you call the world is made up of consciousness. You see, this class will be like this only. I am just exhorting you. This class will be like this only. If you have some commitment for a real world, etc., so you are sitting in a wrong class. I am telling you. So, therefore, the world you perceive is made up of pure consciousness. What you call matter is consciousness itself. Now, I tell you, shall I tell you what is the world that you are talking about? You pay attention, I will tell you. Your conviction that you are looking at a world, you are dealing with a world, your conviction itself is the world. There is no other world. Did you get it? Yeah. Therefore, you question your conviction. Then the world that you think that is there outside will dissolve like a bad dream. So, your conviction that I am living in a world, there is a world other than me, and it is there outside of me, and it makes me sad, it makes me happy, that world, some good things are there in that. That conviction of you is the world. Understand that. Just don't gloss over things saying that there is a world outside. There is no world outside. You are imagining the world. In fact, what you say the world, does it exist in space? Yes, it exists in space. In fact, it moves in space. And that space in which the world moves, and the world in which the world lasts, that space, the time in which this world lasts, and that time, they are you, they are your consciousness alone. Space is none other than space consciousness. time is none other than time consciousness, and the world which moves in this space and which lasts in this time is indeed none other than pure consciousness. That is the drishtanta. Therefore, what you call world, it has no content in itself. The nama-rupa, as nama-rupa, is a glitter, an appearance, it has no content. Then what is its content? The consciousness, the chit alone is its content. That is the meaning of that example, the shankha example. Next drishtanta. Sayatha veenayai vadyamanayai. Here you have come to chaturthi vibhakti. This chaturthi vibhakti is indeed to be converted into shashti vibhakti. Earlier we have seen jayayai, to be converted as jayayaha. This is the Vedic way of the mantras. So they are presented like that. So veenayaha vadyamanayaha. That puts all the examples in the proper context, like shankhasya dvayamanasya. When it comes to strilinga, the chaturthi vibhakti has to be taken as shashti vibhakti. Na bahyan shabdan shaknuyad grahanaya veenayaitu grahanena. Once again, it is veenayaha tu grahanena. Veenavadasyava shabdo gruhitaha. Same thing. But then, still, there is something to be said about it. Like even Bhashyakara says something there. Tatha means in the same way. Veenayai vadyamanayai. Veenayaha vadyamanayaha. Yeah. The chaturthi is converted into shashti. That is the meaning of it. There is nothing more to the chaturthi vibhakti. In strilinga shabdas, it happens all the time. Aneka drushtanto padanam iha samanya bahutva khyapanartham. Here Shankara makes a very interesting analysis of these multiple examples. You see, there are many samanyas. So, like dundubhi samanya, we have shown. And all the dundubhi visheshas, you resolve into dundubhi samanya. This is the process of resolution. Then you realize that tadiganatom, etc., dundubhi shabda visheshas do not exist outside of dundubhi samanya. They are all superimpositions on dundubhi samanya only. So they all got resolved into dundubhi samanya. That is one. Then shankha shabda samanya is there. Samanya is the general. And now bham, bolenath, all of that is resolved into shankha shabda samanya. Then veena samanya is there. Veena means it has a different story about it. I do not know any of these musical instruments and all that except whatever I see occasionally. So veena must be having sa, ri, ga, ma, pa, da, something like that it must be having. They take a string attached to a particular contraption, and so the string must be stretched well. So that a stretched string. In physics sound chapter, there is a chapter called stretched strings. That much I know. I don't know any sarigama padalisa, etc. And so when you take this stretched string and then touch it, it starts vibrating. And the vibration, there are standard frequencies. Like 242 is one standard frequency. 512 is another standard frequency. Like that, some of these standard frequencies are there. And so, different strings have different standard frequencies. There is a name for it, that standard frequency for every string, there is a name for it. It's some original character of that string. So, when the tension of the string is so-and-so, when the diameter of the string is so and so, it will have this much of a lambda value or a frequency value, gamma value, whatever, that it is standard frequency. And so that standard frequency, you hear it and say it is sa. There is no sa in it. It is standard frequency. It is a vibration. You put a sa on its head. You got the point? So reduce it. Don't get carried away by the appearances, by the shapes, by the forms, etc. As long as you think that whatever has a name and form is real, so long you will not understand the truth, okay? Therefore, there is no sa, there is no ri, there is no ga, there is no ma. There is a standard frequency varying, the standard frequency varies with each string. That's why they have 5 or 7 strings. If sa, ri, gamma, etc., all of them are there, why you need 5, 7 strings? Why not just one string? That means what they have there is only one particular frequency will not give you all the sa, ri, gamma, pa. So you need to have multiple strings, and then you need to have multiple fingers also. With one finger, no vena will be possible. Multiple fingers, and so increase or decrease the length of the string. You put the hand here, then this length of the string is decreased. Push the hand up, the length of the string is increased. So, oh, you see, he puts it down and you get ri. He puts it up, you get panjama, panjama swara. You think like that. They are all not there in it. There is only vena shabda samanya. And all these sarigama padana, etc., you are superimposing upon that. And somebody, a musician, will hear this discussion by me. He will get a fit. And then he will say, this Swami is a jada. They call it a jada. Veda jadaha. Or Vedanta jadaha, if you may like to say. You are welcome to say that. So if you want to fancy that there are all these swaras, etc., they are so beautiful, they are this, they are that. If you want to fancy yourself that way, you are welcome to all that. There is no content in it. It is all your pure consciousness. Yes, I will give you, there is a standard example which I have shown to many people earlier. The example is so powerful and it so nicely fits into the discussion. Therefore, I have it with me. Many people know about it. This is what it is. So now I tell you, you have to answer a few questions correctly. What is that? You have to say, it is the glow. That is what it is. It is the glow. Don't bother about this, the liver and all those things are not the point. There is the glow, okay? These multiple things also, don't worry. Just the glow. There is the glow. Now you see. What are you seeing? Oh, yeah, I have to read this here. Now you see. What are you seeing? Let us party. Is that what you are seeing? Okay. Now, is there a glow and glow and glow and glow only? Or suddenly, LETUSPARTY, all of them have taken birth? You can describe. There is only glow now. Sadekameva somyedamagra asit. There is only glow now. Now from this glow, there is the birth srishti of LETUSPARTY is all being created. They are all created. Now they are being sustained by the Parabrahma. He is sustaining in himself. They are all there. And now they are all resolved in Parabrahma. Only glow remains. That is what it is. There is only Atma Jyoti, the light of Atma. You have to understand, just as the fish live in the ocean of water, just as the birds live in the ocean of air, even the humans live in the ocean of air. That is the illustration. So, just so, you live in the ocean of light, the light of Chaitanyam, Chaitanya Jyoti or Atma Jyoti. You live in that ocean of light. The inner light, we call it inner from the standpoint of the body-mind, that inner light is always present. In the deep sleep state, the inner light is present. That is why you have what is called the experience of the sleep state as freshness, a happy joy, and also not knowing anything in particular. Therefore, that inner light is there as you sleep. And then in waking state, that inner light is there. And in the dream state also, that inner light is there. You see, you want to do better meditation, proper meditation. And then you want to slowly progress on the path of self-realization. Then it is absolutely necessary for the students of Vedanta to associate their being, their existence with that inner light. So you have to associate. So you don't wait for it to come and flash before you. It won't happen like that. So you have to understand and associate that I am, I am. You see, I am is an evidence. It is a Puranam. It is a, so my existence is presenting itself. It is evidencing itself. It is evidencing itself. So I am. I am. And then how the I am is becoming evident? Through mind? No. Through eyesight? No. I am is becoming evident because of that light in which it appears. That inner light, Atma. And that light is the same light in which pot, flower, etc., the entire world appears. That is the same light. And therefore, your existence as an as a person, I amness, and then the world in which you interact, you live and all that, the world, the existence of that world, this existence has no meaning except for that inner light. Therefore, you have to associate yourself with that inner light. So, you have to perseveringly bring that inner light into focus, and you have to become conscious of that inner light. This is called antarmukhatvam. It is like, you see, I look at the flower. Even as I look at the flower becomes the other. I am the other. The division is there. And now I categorize the flower as beautiful or ugly. And then I also categorize, I like this flower, I don't like this flower. This is what is called Bahirmukha. Everything is in you only. All this is in you only. Even when you say all these things, flower is outside, I like it, I don't like it, all of it is in you only. But still, in you are Bahirmukha. On the other hand, I do not name it. I do not put the mind to work. I just look at it without the mind. I am aware of its presence. It is not I am looking at the flower. No. It is not like I am looking at the flower. No. I am aware of the presence. You are taking food and then you are talking. Talking means what? Thought is the origin of speech. And therefore you are thinking and the thinking is expressed through the organ of speech as talking. And therefore, when you are thinking of the worldly things. And of course, talking also of the worldly things only. This way, while eating the food, you have become Bahirmukha. You make yourself Bahirmukha. Don't put the mind to work. Means stop thinking. Yes, stop thinking. You won't become a dull or any such thing. Stop thinking for God's sake. Stop thinking. While taking food, stop thinking. As an example. And then, even now you are sitting in the class, suppose you are continuously thinking. Will you understand what I am saying? No. You have to stop thinking and you have to become silent internally. Then only what I say becomes meaningful to you. Same way, in food also, you should do that. Stop thinking. When you stop thinking, I stop thinking. During food, I stop thinking. That's why while I am talking food, if somebody asks me a question, I am a bit dumbfounded for a second or two, but then I start thinking. Then only I can answer your question. Therefore, you just stop thinking while taking food, and then when you stop thinking, you stop talking. There is no talking. You need not stop talking. There will be no talk. And then you be aware of the food. You may say, what is there to be aware of? That is the mind. You don't look for variety and content. You just be aware of what is. Some bland taste thing is in the mouth. Astu, you be aware of that. Then it is now tasting a little sweet. Astu, be aware of that. It is a bit spicy. Astu, be aware of that. So put awareness to work, not mind to work. As you put awareness to work, that is called antarmukha. There itself, it is there itself. It is not, antarmukha is not something different from bahirmukha. There itself you are bahirmukha. There itself we are antarmukha. It is like we have a proverb in Telugu. So, the grain is there. So, there is the husk and there is the grain. It is all there only. Husk, it is there. Grain, it is there. Similarly, bahirmukha, husk, it is there. Antarmukha, the grain, it is there. Therefore, that is how you bring the Atma Jyoti into the focus, bring awareness into the focus. And you see, you are not different from awareness, but I have to use an expression. Therefore, I am saying, therefore, don't put that kind of contradictions or paradoxes on my head. I have to say something, therefore, I am saying. So, bring awareness into focus. Suppose you ask, how can you bring Atma into focus? Then I don't have an answer. I have to look fool, like foolish. Therefore, that is, you have to take the spirit of it, the antarmukha. Therefore, be aware of the food as you are eating food. Be aware of your hands as you are washing hands. Be aware of the tree's general presence. Don't worry about the name of the trees and all that. General presence. Don't be a landscaper. Just be aware. A landscaper means this tree should not be here, it should be there. Now what will you do? So, be aware of the presence of trees, plants, flowers, birds, etc. Don't be a bird watcher. Just be aware of the presence of the birds. Be aware of the presence of everything. That awareness, that is the Atma Jyoti. You have to cultivate it. And as you cultivate it, as I suggested in the meditation, you will realize, you will see that it is not the same world anymore. It is not the same world. World jagat mithya. You will say it. Not I saying or some Shankara saying. You will say it. Because it is not the same world. You are living in the same world because entirely of inadvertence. Never understanding things correctly. Because of inadvertence, because of bahirmukhatvam, you believe that there is a world out there and it makes you bound and sorrowful. If you bring that antarmukhatvam into focus, develop what is called, they call it inner awareness. That is called yoga. So, the inner awareness, when you bring it into focus, then obviously, you are in the same place. The same things are there, the same people are there, the same animals are there, same birds are there, but they are not the same anymore. It's all together, it is out of this world, I tell you. It is not the same world. I cannot tell what it is. You have to experience it, if I may say so, yourself. Therefore, you have to understand that the light of Atma, the awareful being, that alone is real. Every existence, including my own personal existence, so-called personal existence, is nothing more than an appearance in that light, the light of awareness. That is the meaning of this entire discussion. So, what we are saying is, samanya bahutva khyapanartham. Multiple examples are given here. To point out that there are multiple samanyas. Let us say samanya means generality. So, like humans, all human beings, the entire humanity is one. You come to that samanya. Forget about this Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Hindu, Christian, Muslim, Indian, American, Dutch, etc. You forget about all that. Resolve all these visheshas into one samanya. That is manava. Entire humanity is one. Then coming to the trees, bring all of them into one samanya. The entire flora is one. The entire fauna is one. All these samanyas, the generalities, then go and merge in one mahasamanya, which is Atma. Then you can say, Atma is Brahma. Brahma is mahasamanya. Brahma is boundless, limitless, that is Brahma. So, you remain with all your petty-mindedness and smallness, and yet, how can you know that Atma is Brahma? There is no way of knowing. Therefore, expand and expand. Become divergent, expansive, be expansive. Expand yourself continuously. In that, then all these samanyas will have to finally merge in that mahasamanya, which is Brahma, which is the light of awareness. That is what is called Atmacha Brahma. That is what is called Tattvamasi. So, Bhashyakara. Anekehi vilakshanaha chetana chetana rupaha samanya visheshaha. Samanya visheshaha means samanya bhedaha. You see, all living beings are there. So you start with your own samanyas, general awareness. General awareness. See, you have to develop general awareness and you have to move away from curiosity and some such thing, related thing. So like there is a person. Suppose here is a person coming. Here is a person coming. Hey, who is that coming? American jaisa dikhta hai. Americans like, appears like an American. Oh, come on, not American. He is a North Indian. Oh, North Indian? No, not North Indian. He is a Punjabi. So, don't be like that. That is not the way. So, if you have to give something to him or take something from him, all that can go on. But you need not cut humanity into pieces like that. That is not necessary. And so, you don't do all that mistake. You expand and make one mahasamanya, one samanya, not mahasamanya, mahasamanya is Brahma, one samanya of the humanity. Then, you see, I love roses. Why should you love roses? You should love every blade of grass. Why should you love roses? Who asked you to love roses? You should not do such silly things. I am not talking about art and art forms and all. Don't go into all that. There are books, so keep the books and start reading it. I am not talking about all that. Books of roses. So, you make one samanya of the entire flora. One samanya. Suppose rose is there. I will pluck it and put inside the home. Suppose some wild flower is there. I will uproot it and throw away. Why should you do all that? Why not have just a samanya? Why should you make one liked and the other disliked? Don't do that. Make it one samanya, vruksha samanya, pakshi samanya. One particular dog is my dog. Why do you do that? Don't do that. There is nothing like my dog. So all pakshi samanya, pasu samanya, these are chetana samanyas. Then come to achetana, achetana samanyas. Oh, you see, I tell you how achetana samanya. This I like this. This achetana samanya. You see, somebody said, Swamiji, when you go to America, you miss Ganga and Godavari. There are no Ganga and Godavari in America. Then I said, I don't miss Ganga and Godavari. Because Delaware is there. Delaware cannot be Ganga. What is the difference? For me, Delaware is Ganga. Delaware is Ganga, Mississippi is Ganga, Nile is Ganga, every river, Amazon is Ganga, every river is Ganga. River Samanya. Poconos are as sacred as Himalayas. Parvata Samanya. Prithivi, suppose Prithivi. So, this example I am not sure how well you take it. So, that also you should make a Savalya. Really, I know a Mahatma. He said, wherever this body falls, take it to the nearest cremation ground and surrender it to the earth. Don't carry it here and there in boxes or in flights or in cars. Take it to the nearest cremation ground. Otherwise, you will be, you cremate it then and there, it becomes illegal and all that. So don't fall into all those problems. So take it to the nearest permitted cremation ground and burial ground, not cremation ground, and just surrender it to the earth. And then leave it alone. Don't do anything more with it. Don't put one stupam around it. Some cement structure don't put. Don't mark it. Because if you mark, then some people would like to visit that. Don't mark it. Ekshantaka vasiyat, if you may like to read it, probably. Just. Then a question is asked, don't you want to be buried on the sacred banks of River Ganga? Then he said, Prithivi Samanya. Every square inch of earth is like sacred bank of Ganga only. Prithivi Samanya. So, you may wonder what I am doing, what am I saying. But I assure you, you have to train yourself in this direction. If you want to know Atmacha Brahma. If you see Atmacha Brahma is not urgent, some cultural things and some music, dance, drama, etc., these are important, and you have to do something about it, you are welcome to all that. I am not saying anything against it. All that is wonderful, fine. You may continue to love your roses. I am not coming in the way. So, you may do all that. But don't again say Atmacha Brahma. Because not that I will come and stop you, because you are contradicting yourself. So please make note of that. And therefore, that is how all you make samanyas here and there. The chetana samanyas, achetana samanyas. And now you have multiple samanyas. Okay? You have arrived at stage one. Multiple samanyas. Tesham पारंपर्यगत्या यथा एकस्मिन् महासामान्ये अंतर्भावः प्रज्ञानघने कथं नाम प्रदर्शयितव्यः. सो द श्रुति इट इज नाउ शंकर ही इज डेमोंस्ट्रेटिंग द विजन ऑफ द श्रुति. The Shruti is thinking like this, I have to make these people, first bring them to multiple samanyas. These people are horribly lost in the names and forms of, variety of names and forms. They are lost in these jungles of names and forms. In every samanya, there is a jungle of names and forms. One more samanya, another jungle of names and forms. So this is how the people are badly lost in the jingles of names and forms. Let me first push them towards multiple samanyas. So like all jewelry is one gold, make one samanya there. All trees are one kind of a life form, make a samanya there. Make one, very urgently make one samanya of the entire humanity. Very urgently you do that. Don't wait one second more about it. You had enough of divisions, now it is time to unite. So one samanya you make there. All animals you make one samanya. Like that, push these guys into multiple samanyas. And once you make them come to that level, The next step is one more step. This is called parampara. Gati means moving. Paramparya gatya. Like you put staircase. Staircase is an example for paramparya gati. So, one step. You step on that. Param, there is a higher step. Now you step on that. Again param, one more higher step. Step on it. So parat param, parat param, parat param. You move forward. This is called parampara. Paramparayaha bhavaha paramparyam. Paramparyagati. So first let them come to one level of multiple samanyas. And then having come to that level, probably it should be easy to push them into one mahasamanya. So these multiple samanyas can be ekasmin mahasamanye antarbhavaha. Just like this jingle of names and forms you are able to resolve in one samanya, similarly a number of samanyas can be conveniently resolved in one mahasamanya, the universal samanya. And what is that mahasamanya? Prajnanaghane, that is the mahasamanya. Prajnanaghana. You see, prajnanaghana means it is prajnana and prajnana and prajnana and prajnana and nothing else. That is prajnanaghane. That is the mahasamanya. So, the prithivi samanya resolves in mahasamanya. The apsamanya, all waters are sacred, all waters are pure. All waters are Ganga only. Apsamanya, resolve that in mahasam, prajnana samaghana. Then vayu samanya, resolved in prajnana ghana. Agni samanya, resolved in prajnana ghana. Akasha samanya, resolved in prajnana ghana. Then all human samanya, pakshi samanya, pasu samanya, every samanya is now resolved in one prajnana ghana. How would we be able to do it? Kathannama pradarshayitavyaha. How well can I point out this truth to these guys? This is the intent of the Shruti. That is how Shruti is looking at the people. And therefore, the Shruti thought, that by putting multiple examples, probably I can nudge these guys to that mahasamanya level. That is the purpose of giving multiple examples. That is how Shankara presents it. You see, I tell you, there is a crystal and the transparent diamond-like crystal. And then this crystal, when it is put on the side of a black piece of cloth, it appears black. You put the crystal by the side of a red piece of cloth, it appears red. The same way, I am just describing one samanya, human samanya. The same way, you see, in spite of appearing black, in spite of appearing red, the crystal is neither black nor red. It is what it is. It is pure crystal. Similarly, take this I am, ahamasmi. This is what is called the awareness of one's own being. Or it can be otherwise called awareful being. Take that. Now, this I am, a man in India will say, I am an Indian. And a man in America will say, I am an American. Like this black cloth, the crystal appears like a nela money, and with the red cloth, the crystal appears like a ruby. It is neither nela money nor ruby. It is pure crystal. Similarly, when a person says, I am Indian, that I am is not Indian. I am is what it is, pure, awareful being. And when a person says, I am an American, I am, it continues to be the same. It is the pure, awareful being. I am a Christian, still it is a pure, awareful being. I am a Hindu, pure, awareful being. So I am MA, Master of Arts, or I am PhD. Still it is pure, awareful being. I am illiterate, I did not go to school. Still pure, awareful being. I am white, still pure, awareful being. I am black, still pure, awareful being. Then, the lion has the same expression of I am. the tiger has the same expression of I am. A dog has the same expression of I am. One student asked me, how do you know a dog has the same expression of I am? I told, did you ever observe a dog when it comes across another dog? Did you observe? If you observe, this time you observe, you will know that the dog also has the same expression of I am. Really, it wags its tail and it leaves this guy thinks I am the owner of the dog, and the dog, it just leaves you alone. In 1 second, it just ditches this guy and runs towards the other dog. It has that expression of I am in it. And so, every animal has the same expression of I am, that I am, that pure I am. Forget about all these expressions. That pure I am is all pervading, because it is in all life forms. It is unchanging in man and in woman and in animal and in bird and in a small creature. It is unchanging and it is universal. So that I am is a samanya. And that I am samanya, first you have to arrive at. And then that I am samanya merges in prajnana ghana. Then when that I am samanya merges in prajnana ghana, then only you can say, aham brahmasmi. First you have to say, aham asmi. And arrive at maha samanya. And then when you understand this aham asmi, which is the awareful being, it is universal, it is unchanging, it is all-pervading. When you understand that I am-ness that way, then you will add the word Brahma. So that is the paramparagati, paramparagati. You have to move in that direction. So till then, you may not say aham brahmasmi. No fun in saying aham brahmasmi. It sounds a bit odd also. Aham brahmasmi, it sounds a bit odd. Because we are saying something which we do not mean. So this is how the samanya parampara takes us to the mahasamanya, which is the prajnana ghana. And the Shruti wanted to show it all. Therefore, iti dundubhishankha vena shabda samanya visheshanam yatha shabdatve antarbhavaha. So he is explaining that paramparagati, how tadhiginatom, etc., are resolved in dundubhi shabda samanya. Then sarigamapa, etc., are resolved in veena shabda samanya. Bham bham bhum, etc., are resolved in shankha shabda samanya. Now having done that, now take the three shabda samanyas. Dundubhi samanya, shankha samanya, veena samanya. And now resolve it in pure shabda samanya. Shabda samanya antarbhavaha. Now, like even different swaras resolve in the veena and similarly, etc., all these different instruments, general sound characters, also resolve in one shabda, which is pure space. Shabda samanya antarbhavaha. This is how the resolution has to happen. So we will complete that class, that mantra in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate. Shanti Shanti Harihi Om Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.